The Lion and the Mouse, a retelling of Aesop's fable. The Lion and the Mouse, Mark White. This is a fable, and a fable is a story that teaches a lesson. And in some fables, animals may talk and act the way people do. One afternoon, a mouse set off in search of a snack. There he goes. As he walked, the mouse closed his eyes and sniffed. And when he opened his eyes again, he was in front of a huge snoring lion. The mouse tried to sneak away, but the lion woke up with a great big yawn. And the lion caught the mouse under his huge paw. "It looks like I have found a snack," he said. "Please let me go," begged the little mouse. "I am just a little mouse." "You are lucky," said the lion. "I am in a good mood. I will give you your freedom."
"Thank you," the mouse said. "If you ever need my help, I will return the favor."
The lion laughed. "Ha, ha, ha! How could you ever help me?" "Don't worry, you have your freedom. You owe me nothing." And he walked away. The mouse went on his way, searching for a snack, but suddenly he heard a strange noise. The mouse followed the noise, and he found the lion trapped in a net.
"I'll help you,"
shouted the mouse. "What can you do?" asked the lion. "Go away before you get caught too." But the mouse stayed. He climbed up the tree and chewed on the net. His teeth were not as sharp as the lion's, but they were very sharp. Soon the lion was free from the net. "You helped me when I needed it," the lion said. "I owe you my life."
"Don't worry," said the mouse. "You have your freedom. You owe me nothing."
And the new friends walked into the jungle together.
"You didn't think I could help you," said the mouse, "but an act of kindness is never wasted."
I think that's the moral of the story. An act of kindness is never wasted.